features which is of gastrointestinal family, which is most commonly present in beans, spines, and grasses. Grasses of being in all grasses may be present. And fusarium, all the people have got this fusarium, but where it is infected and all the morphology is. So, this is also from Ascomycota, and it is as fusarium can infect fruits and vegetables. As like that, it also be present in tomato plants and all the fruits, vegetable plants. Next one is the Pulmonaria. Pulmonaria is from the phylum of Ascomycota, and it presents generally in group and shoots of all endophytic fungi. And this is what I took, and this is the four endophytic fungi, majorly present and common endophytic fungi. Just we are now going to see about the benefits of endophytic fungi. The benefits which are for plant by endophytic fungi is mainly of defense. When once an endophytic fungi invaded into the plant, it can able to give an indirect and a direct defense from any herbivores and any other insects, birds, and a lot. Then it could help the plant to control the nutrients and the molecules and water too. Like giving many benefits to plant. And it helps for roots and shoots to suck the nutrients and elements. As like mycorrhizae, it helps a lot. And even I told you, the endosymbiotic, it is a mutual relationship. The benefit of fungi in a plant is fungi can get a shelter from this plant. So both are great, so it's a mutualistic. And further studies of endophytic fungi also that for other beneficial uses from many plants and parachi and for tomato, many other